Sally, it's absolutely fantastic to have you here with us at Birmingham Memorabilia. Have you been enjoying it so far?
Yes, it's been really, really busy. I mean, there's just been crowds all morning so far. So yeah, I'm having a great time, thank you.
You've obviously met fans this morning and perhaps before. Have you had any particularly memorable fan encounters? Any strange ones? Any funny ones? Any ones that meant a lot to you?
Well, yes, because sometimes you get the same people who come back. You know, I come about every 4 or 5 years. And when I do come, the same fans come often. And they ask how you are, and they're friendly, and they buy new photographs that you might have, and it's lovely. And there was one occasion, a guy wrote to me, and I used to be their pin-up at university a long time ago, and I said, oh, please come to... He wrote me this letter, a fan letter. I said, please come to Memorabilia. And he did, and that was meant a lot to me, really. And he brought all his university friends, who were now grown up. So wasn't that nice?
It's always nice to be a pin-up. Now, I guess... When people do meet you, what are the most common questions? What do people normally like to ask you about? What do you get?
They usually want to know what it was like to work with Sid James. And I always say the same thing. It was fantastic because he was such a lovely man. And I never get tired of talking about Sid because he was so nice.
Let's start with the Carry On films. I mean, it's a franchise which continues to live on around the world. People still love it. What do you think it was about the franchise that made it so timeless? Why do people still love these films all these years later?
I think because they're funny. Basically funny, aren't they? They're inoffensive. They're not crude in any way. They're fun. They're family films. And they're just plain funny. And it was like a club, the Carry On team. And I think that once you were in it, you felt honoured. I know I did. I made 3 and I was felt privileged to be in it. And people like you, once you're in a Carry On film, they think, oh, she's one of the Carry On team.
How close are the Carry On team to the characters that we've come to know and love?
I think the characters are probably very different in real life. Sid was certainly a very different man to what he portrayed on screen. He was a quiet, sophisticated man, delightful, very, very smart, you know, and of course that wasn't his image. He was a gall-blimey, have a laugh, wasn't he, in the Carry On film. So he was very different. But he did have that lovely sense of humour. That was Sid's humour. And I'd say the same about the others. Kenneth Williams, I liked Kenneth Williams. I got on very well with him. He was great. But he wasn't all, I think he had to like you. If he liked you, you were okay. But if he didn't, I don't know.
Looking back, do you have a particular experience on set that stands out for you? Anyone in particular that makes you smile or laugh every time you think about it?
Well, it was with a different film, actually. And it was a screen test I did for a film called Twinkie. And I had to do a love scene with Charles Bronson, the actor of Death Wish. And it was when he was in his most gorgeous days. And I remember thinking, oh, is this really happening? And he had to kiss me. And that was quite nice. I thought, oh, yeah, I'll remember this all my life.
Of course, apart from making wonderful films, you've also been a big star on our small screens, working with Sid again. I mean, can you talk a little bit about why that series was so popular and why you think it ran for as long as it did?
Yeah, well, Bless His House, the television series, was a new vehicle for Sid. He'd never played a family man before. And here he was. It was written by Vince Powell. And Carla Lane were writers as well, Dave Freeman. And they made this marvellous series for Sid as a family man, and it worked. It was a chance, you know, but it worked. And I think the public could identify with the family, the two troublesome teenagers. And I was quite sweet. I was a daddy's girl. I was a daddy's girl, and I think they liked that as well. And Diana Coupland, who played my mother, she used to get fan mail, and women would ask Diana, they'd say, oh, I've got a real problem with my daughter. How do you cope with Sally? Of course, that wasn't really her daughter. But Diana was very nice, but she wrote back.
My final question. We're going to release you and let you get back to fans here today. But do you have a message for all the Carry On fans out there watching this? Anything you'd like to say to all of them?
Oh, yes. Carry On fans, fantastic. You know, I'm so glad you love the Carry On films too. And I hope it passes down in generations. And I'm sure it will.